Thanks to Alchemy for sponsoring this video and making it possible to practice organic chemistry examples in an effective and playful way. You can follow along with me and we'll try this question together using the Mechanisms app. The link to download this app is in the description. And this question is part of their Essentials pack, which is free. It's under the third section of Addition. It's number 5. If you need a refresher on the general mechanism of hydrohalogenation, then check out my previous video. On to our example of an alkene that is not symmetrical. Step 1 is protonation. This is where the electrons in the double bond reach out and grab the hydrogen. Electrons from this bond now go to the bromine, and our bromine is now negatively charged since it gained electrons. Okay, so where does the hydrogen go? Does it go to this carbon or does it go to the other carbon? Only one is going to be correct. This is known as being regioselective, meaning the hydrogen is selective or just picky as to which carbon it attaches to. If we were to have the hydrogen go to this first carbon, it would be wrong. And thankfully, the Mechanisms app can help you avoid that mistake thanks to their hint feature. This carbocation is not the most stable. Remember that a tertiary carbocation is the most stable and most favorable. Then a secondary carbocation follows, and primary, and last is a methyl carbocation. We know a carbocation is tertiary if there are three carbons attached to the carbocation. Two carbons attached to the carbocation is secondary, one carbon is primary, and no carbons attached to the carbocation would be the methyl. So in this case, our tertiary carbocation is the most stable, so the hydrogen would favor the least substituted carbon. Now that we have the correct carbocation, step 2 is to have our nucleophile, which is bromine, attack the carbocation to form our product. If you notice, the hydrogen went to the least substituted carbon, and the halogen went to the most substituted carbon. This is Markovnikov's rule. Another way to remember this is we always want the most stable carbocation. So first, make sure to get the most stable carbocation, so a tertiary carbocation if possible. Then do a nucleophilic attack to form our product, which in this case was a tertiary alkyl bromide. Do this next question on your own using the Mechanisms app. There are hints to help you avoid mistakes, and in the Essentials pack, there's even a video to guide you step by step. The link to download this app is in the description, and to find this exact question, click on the Essentials pack, then it's the third topic under Addition, and it's number 8. I'll see you in the next video, where we'll cover when to use a hydride and alkyl shift.